flashlight.
It's on.
Beautiful night out there. Looks like the fog cleared out. It's over the rooftops. Welcome. It's 8:30.
Thank you for choosing freeconferencecall.com.
Just getting on the phone. Welcome to St. Paul's Church in Nantucket. Chris from the Attic. My map of Block Island. America's Cup when it was in Newport. Okay,
off.
Flashlight off.
It's off.
It's off.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh, Carol is in her hair. That humidity out there is saying her curls are losing out. How about your curls at our wedding? Like, you couldn't tell with all the headdress and everything. Yes.
It's the
80s.
That's a bad hairdo.
No. My lobster with the birthday crown. Oh, I didn't make your birthday crown. I should have done that next birthday. You didn't bring your flush and your sparkle shoes up, though, Ollie.
No.
I got a one nice thing.
I can't see my feet during this show, so it's service.
Oh, well, we could adjust the camera.
No.
Scallop shell, symbol of baptism.
Oh.
Yeah, right, yes. Yes, yes, yes.
Okay,
Ollie. You're right on time, Ollie, according to that clock. I can adjust this.
Oh, yep.
Still on?
Yeah.
There we go. We got all our flat couple of banners there.
Oh, look at those sunflowers. They're pretty.
I know.
They're pretty.
So I'm going to clean up
look at how cute they are. So chocolatey and...
Oh, look at those.
Yeah.
Nice enough.
This is a special variety. I grew this type once successfully and...
Yeah, most of our sunflowers in Delaware were
our
parishioners Helen and Carolyn at St. George's Chapel gave us bird seed when we arrived in 2001, and then until we left, those generation after generation, every summer we had those multiple flowers, you know, 25 bud, you know, blooms on each stalk, sunflowers. We did have one poor year. Ollie had like eggplant colored, you know, sunflowers and beautiful orange sunflowers. And we came out one Sunday morning and they'd been harvested by, this is a sad story. Someone had taken them, they weren't ripped down. Like sometimes people would rip at our sunflowers because it was right out by the sidewalk. And it was a, you know, busy enough street down by the beach. But someone must have had a wedding and they get a nice dozen, you know, one of those exotic sunflowers which usually don't do as well as the birdseed ones. So what's the lesson, Ollie? Stick to the birdseed sunflowers.
Yeah, and those were prolific.
The birds love them.
And they had multiple flowers.
Those yellow birds.
They're absolutely beautiful.
The yellow birds are all over them.
But there's so many varieties of sunflowers now. You know, it's really, it's exciting. You're in the seed store or the store that sells the seeds and you see them and you go bananas. I do. I gotta try all of these, you know. But it's tough. It's the birdseed seed that seems to come up the best, the strongest.
Yeah, it's like wild sunflowers.
And doesn't get eaten by bugs. Do you know what I mean? So.
I know.
And
we have some nice native plants coming up on the probably the small garden here. But some nice native plants, which in the fall, the bees were all over.
Mm-hmm.
But when they finally did like the last thing to bloom.
So my Sconset sun, those are my Baltimore sunflowers from Linda. And then my secret Sconset sunflowers are out on the front stoop.
On the stoop as we
have
gracing the front stoop.
It's a live plant and it needs sun and water and that kind of thing. So they're out there keeping the geraniums company. So thank you to my secret sconset sunflower gifter.
I know, and today we had sconset.
Hi, Erica.
Lobster salad delivered.
Oh yes.
Low sodium sconset lobster salad, sure, which is another. We're not worthy, Lord, but we'll take it. We'll receive it anyways.
Josie, Melissa, and Ellie. All right, shall we start?
Page 127. Ellie, we're right on time. 127. Okay, order for Compline. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much for gathering with us and such kind words of encouragement, Ellie, today from several directions. The Lord Almighty grant us a peaceful night and a perfect end.
Amen.
Our help is in the name of the Lord,
the maker of heaven and earth.
Let us confess our sins to God. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought and word and deed, and in what we have left undone. For the sake of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, forgive us all our offenses and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. May the mighty God grant us forgiveness of all our sins and the grace and comfort of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Alleluia, Zali. They're in season still, you know. Right up to Lent. One alleluia. Don't get carried away. Like our verger, which we love. Triple alleluias. Oh, look, I lost my page. But I know the psalm is Psalm 85, and I missed my...
Okay, so Psalm 85, can easily find, if we're familiar with the Book of Common Prayer.
Better when it's this... Look at this. It's in Japanese, this bookmark. Where do I get this anyway? It's interesting. Anyone read Japanese? Of course, it's backwards.
Mm-hmm. So...
It's on page 708, Ali. 708.
708.
Psalm 85. And this is a psalm assigned for the feast day, which is St. John the Baptist. Am I in this picture, Ali? Yes, I am. Enough of me is.
Okay.
I'll pray up to the asterisk, Ali, and you and the congregation can complete the verse. You've been gracious to your land, O Lord.
You have restored the good fortune of Jacob.
You've forgiven the iniquity of your people
and blotted out all their sins.
You've withdrawn all your fury
and turned yourself from the wrathful indignation.
Restore us then, O God, our Savior.
Let your anger depart from us.
Will you be displeased with us forever?
Will you prolong your anger from age to age?
Will you not give us life again?
That your people may rejoice in you.
Show us your mercy, O Lord,
and grant us your salvation.
Oh, listen to what the Lord God is saying.
For he is speaking peace to his faithful people and to those who turn their hearts to him.
Truly his salvation is very near to those who fear him,
that his glory may dwell in our land.
Mercy and truth have met together.
Righteousness and peace have kissed each other.
Truth shall spring up from the earth,
and righteousness shall look down from heaven.
Lord will indeed grant prosperity,
and our land will yield its increase.
Righteousness shall go before him,
and peace shall be a pathway for his feet.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia. Confident as alleluia's I. Confident.
Okay.
Alleluia. So what do we have? Time for Bible reading.
Oh, I don't see that.
Did Meatball steal the Bible again?
I see the hymnal. I see my prayer book.
Am I sitting on it? Oh, it's your feet, Alice. Let me get it for you.
Oh, it's to the left of my left foot. Okay. Okay, here it is.
Take your time, Alice. We've got time.
Just check this out, right?
Yeah, it's a yeah, that's right.
This time?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, what chapter are we? It looks like we're in chapter one. Chapter a little bit long, Ali. Okay. If you need water, let me know.
Okay, so tonight's scripture reading is chapter 1 of Luke, a reading from the Gospel to Luke, chapter 1, verse 57.
Gospel according to Luke.
A reading from the Gospel according to Luke, okay. Now the time came to Elizabeth to give birth, and she bore a son. Her neighbors and relatives heard that the Lord had shown his great mercy to her, and they rejoiced with her. On the eighth day, they came to circumcise the child, and they were going to name him Zechariah after his father. But his mother said, "No, he is to be called John." They said to her, "None of your relatives has this name." Then they began motioning to his father to find out what name he wanted to give him. He asked for a writing tablet and wrote, "His name is John." And all of them were amazed. Immediately his mouth was opened and his tongue freed, and he began to speak, praising God. Fear came over all their neighbors, and all these things were talked about throughout the entire hill country of Judea. All who heard them pondered them and said, "What then will this child become? For indeed the hand of the Lord was with him." Then his father Zechariah was filled with the Holy Spirit and spoke this prophecy, "Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he has looked favorably on his people and redeemed them. He has raised up a mighty Savior for us in the house of his servant David, as he spoke through the mouth of his holy prophets from of old, that he would be saved from our enemies and from the hand of all who hate us. Thus he has shown the mercy promised to our ancestors and has remembered his holy covenant, the oath that he swore to our ancestor Abraham, to grant us that we, being rescued from the hands of our enemies, might serve him without fear in holiness and righteousness before him all our days. And you, child, will be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his ways, to give knowledge of salvation to his people by the forgiveness of their sins, by the tender mercy of our God. The dawn from on high will break upon us to give light to those who sit in darkness and in the shadow of death, to guide our feet into the way of peace." The child grew and became strong in spirit, and he was in the wilderness until the day he appeared publicly to Israel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. You did your work tonight, Ali, over time with a long gospel. A sign for tonight, because today is one of the important feast days of the year.
No.
The feast of the Nativity of St. John the Baptist, so his birth. I think maybe a more interesting story might have been his baptizing. You know, the story of the baptism of Jesus, that John was out in the wilderness proclaiming repentance of sins. And he said, "One coming after me, whose sandals I'm unfit to untie, will lead you into all peace." Thanks, Helen. So yes, this is... my Ten Commandments ribbon. Where did I get this? Was one of...
I don't know. I think for the Martin Luther King dinner, maybe?
Millsboro, Delaware. Millsboro. So the Feast of John the Baptist. Of course, in the early church, there's some confusion. Is this prophet, John the Baptist, actually the Messiah? He had quite a following. Matter of fact, for generations, there were an offshoot of Christianity that really revered John the Baptist. It's quoted in these Gospels, John the Baptist himself saying, no, no one coming after me. And of course, the story of poor John the Baptist beheaded, some of the classic paintings of John the Baptist, his head's on a platter, and beheaded. He got a little too political, and King Herod had him beheaded. But it was, when I always say, Ollie, on my tombstone someday, because of what I put under Max Joseph Wolff on my tombstone, what would be my epitaph?
It would be husband, priest, Baptizer.
Now there's a fourth one from Living on Nantucket.
Oh, Family Scalloper.
Family Scalloper. Our friend Adam Dredd always introduces me as, this is Father Max, a Family Scalloper for Jesus. Because I'm not a commercial scalloper, I'm a Family Scalloper. Family Scalloper for Jesus. I've added, I looked at the scallop shell maybe. You know how they, this classic, we had great, down in Delaware, we had old cemetery from the early 1700s. And like hands pointing up to heaven, things like that. You know, interesting, those old colonial images were quite striking. But I think a scallop shell, also a symbol of baptism, which is, we share in the death and resurrection of Christ in our baptism. I think it's so great. At on our window, which I posted earlier, and I'm going to post a close-up of it, is John the Baptist is baptizing Jesus. Do you know what river that was, Ollie? It's a... you know, that'd be a test. This is the one I... You know when I work with families over baptism.
River Jordan, right?
River Jordan, yeah. Yes. River Jordan. But several families have guessed the Thames. I told you about that. Jesus first went to England to be baptized, then went to Oklahoma. This is an old joke now, when this person in the attic, and met with Joseph Smith. Is that where Joseph Smith had prophetic encounters on it?
Where? I thought that was in Oklahoma.
I said in Oklahoma,
oh,
yeah.
Okay.
But first he was baptized in the Thames.
Oh, okay.
But then many people guess the Nile. But it's River Jordan. The River Jordan. And so that's a test for baptismal couples. It's amazing how many people don't get that one. It's one of those trivial questions. And people fail. And so shows us, Ollie, we need to read this book a little bit a little bit more. But you get it, Ollie, the Jordan River. Also, I often say, often they call it the river what? The river what? But for the still.
Well.
So anyways, the Thames as good as any. And so, and tomorrow, of course, I mentioned I have a baptism in Nantucket Sound.
Tomorrow you have a baptism on Nantucket
Sound.
Yeah,
so I'm going to park at the...
Oh, listen to this.
I know Debbie's on, Debbie Spears here. Debbie, I'm going to park at the Gaza Strip, right in the street at the Galley.
That's right, Debbie, you need
I'm
going to
walk
there.
Way down. So Debbie, pray, if you're down in the Gaza Strip at high tide, which is at 4-ish, I looked at my tide chart, luckily. But yeah, so lovely person. Doctor from Nashville. Again, we have great connections to Nashville with Pastor Fuzz, we pray for every night and day and night. And for Adam Dredd, our dear counselor friend, who gives me advice by text messaging me out. We have to send him his, when you have a lawyer. Not a claimer, but a, some fee. A terrible
what is it called?
What's it called, everyone?
I know.
To be your lawyer.
It's on the tip of my tongue. I really want to answer this question, so move on.
Okay,
so
baptism. And of course, we believe in, and as I talked to this wonderful young doctor from Nashville being baptized tomorrow, what a blessing it is to share in the life of our baptism. And God loves us whether we're baptized or not. There's no restrictions in our church about baptism for membership or anything. But tomorrow I have to pray for to make all of Nantucket Sound baptismal water. So those that are swimming at high tide, you'll feel extra fresh, born again in the waters of baptism. Would you whisper to me? Hurry
retainer.
Up. A retainer. See, look at Did you read that? Oh, thank you. Thank you.
No, I didn't read that. Thank you, Janet. I did not read that. I came to my...
You know. I know. You shouldn't have your glasses on even, but thanks, Janet. I hope you haven't had to pay one. But you probably did with the shoddy work that you had. Yeah, with the shoddy work.
He'll be expecting his retainer.
Yeah, Adam's one of my... And again, we have a great lawyer, Frank Robinson, who looks at... He'll look at a contract and he'll protect us from... Remember one time I had a... Frank, you're going to love this if you're watching. I signed a rental agreement, and there were multiple copies because we had like four sections of this retail space. It used to be a grocery store and different things. And it was at a rundown shopping center with big potholes, but this was a thrift shop. I think it still is down there, a parish thrift shop. Good amount of space. So anyways, I signed them all. And if we didn't leave by a certain number of months after our lease was up, there'd be a 10% increase per month. Except for one of the ones I signed was 100% increase per month. And they put it on, oh, Father Max, sign these. And luckily, they didn't hold us to it. We still haven't been, you know, getting received notice that we'd be clearing out of there. But what it shows you, Ali, is always have a counselor worth keeping on retainer and read the fine print before you sign anything,
oh,
right?
Heavens.
You're probably better about that than me. And so it's nice to have people that look at those details. I know Paul down in the All Saints, he's on the Way Home board, because of his law experience in Washington.
Is this someone down
there? Yeah, Christian down in Delaware. He really stick with the details. So that's all I know, Ali, about baptism. Again, we believe, not washing away some original sin, I talked about last night, celebrating God's mercy. But also, thank you, Ali, we're running out of power. and so that's which moved me along. But that we're baptized but anointed by the Holy Spirit, Ali, anointed in our baptism and sharing the resurrection of Christ. So John the Baptist, we celebrate him today. And we celebrate our baptism. Okay. New life. Mm-hmm. New life now, newness of life. Mm-hmm. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We could always plug in, Ali, then we could, we'll get your glitter shoes, and we can, because it plugs down there, we'll have to broadcast from our ankles.
Mm-hmm.
So our hymn tonight is one about, not the river, not the Thames, Ali, but the Jordan, and it's on Jordan's Bank, hymn number 76 in the Navy Blue Hymnal, as Ali calls it. And so we're good, Ali, 20%.
Okay.
Phone power. Okay, you know this one. It's an Advent hymn, On Jordan's Bank. Do we know it, Ali? On Jordan's bank the Baptist cry announces that the Lord is nigh. Awake and hearken, for he brings glad tidings of the King of Kings. Then cleansed be every breast from sin, make straight the way for God within. And let each heart prepare a home where such a mighty guest may come. For thou art our salvation, Lord, our refuge and our great reward. Without thy grace we waste away like flowers that wither and decay. To heal the sick, stretch out thine hand and bid the fallen sinner stand. Shine forth and let thy light restore earth's own true loveliness once more. All praise, eternal Son, to thee, whose advent doth thy people free.
With the
Father we adore, and Holy Spirit evermore.
Okay.
Winchester New Olive, that's pretty nice, huh?
Okay, very good.
1690. We love the contemporary songs. 1690, not hip hop, but not far from it.
Okay. So let's go on to page 132, halfway down the page.
Keeping us moving.
Yep.
Before we run out of power.
No jibber jabber.
We're out of power. We'll see you tomorrow night. Okay, 132. I mean, jibber jabber. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
For you have redeemed me, O Lord, O God of truth.
Keep us, O Lord, as the apple of your eye.
Hide us under the shadow of your wings.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let our cry come to you.
Let us pray. Be present, O merciful God. Protect us through the hours of this night, so that we who are wearied by the changes and chances of this life may rest in your eternal changelessness. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Here's a prayer for vocation and daily work. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, you declare your glory and show forth your handiwork in the heavens and in the earth. Deliver us in our various occupations from the service of self alone, that we do the work you give us to do in truth and beauty, and for the common good, for the sake of him who came among us as one who serves, your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. And keep watch, dear Lord, with those who work or watch or weep this night. Give your angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, Lord Christ. Give rest to the weary. Bless the dying. Soothe the suffering. Pity the afflicted. Shield the joyous and all for your love's sake. Amen.
Amen,
Ollie. Oh, I forgot my honey, Ollie. John the Baptist ate locusts and wild honey. We used to have grasshoppers near our house, Ollie, that would be like in your book bag when you arrived at school. Honey, I like. Locusts, I'm not going to eat unless I'm really desperate, Ollie. Maybe in Alaska in the wild. That's a cup of chocolate, Ollie. So our prayers and intercessions, thanksgivings.
Okay, so this evening we ask for your prayers for Marina.
Thank you.
And her husband Richard and Sally Ann. We ask for your prayers for Pat, our dear friend Pat, for good results from a test she's having. We pray for Jason.
Yes, Jason, hold up in prayer for also his doctors, technicians.
We pray for St. John the Evangelist in Vertientes, Cuba. We pray for...
San Juan Evangelista. I think I have to learn the Spanish name for it, Ali. Now that you've learned the town.
San Juan the Evangelista. We pray, we give thanksgiving for Lindsley's recovery.
Yes.
Very happy to hear about that, Lindsley. We pray for... Carl and Angela and Ruthie and Brookie. We pray for our Bishop Alan Gates, his wife Tricia, and our suffragan Bishop Gail Harris. We pray for Renee Martini, a hero in animal rescue. I can assure you of that.
Pray for our cat Esme and for the offshore animal hospital taking care of her tonight.
She's got an issue that's come up.
Yeah.
We pray for Christine's sister Lorraine and her family. We pray for June and Alan, for Josie, Melissa, and Ellie. We pray for Les Slate on Block Island. We pray for and all of our Block Island family and friends, especially St. Anne's Episcopal Church. We pray for Diane and Mozart, and we pray for our friends Linda and Janet and Pat. And we pray for Blair and Missy for recovery for both of you. Mm-hmm. We pray for Joseph.
Hate it when I fold.
Yeah, we pray for Joseph. We pray for Adam.
Look forward to your visit, Joseph.
We pray for Marianne and Julie and Andrew and their children. And we pray for Normand and Ben. We pray for Skylar and Paula. And we pray for those serving in the armed forces and their families. Please, if you know of anyone in the armed forces you'd like us to pray for, we'd love to. On our list, we have Callick and Justin and Trevor.
Our nephew Justin, Johnny's boy.
Our nephew Justin and Callick, a friend of ours, son. We pray for Trevor, and we pray for Lucas, my roommate from college's son, Lucas, and we pray for our dear friend Jeff, who works with returning troops, helping them
return to full health, mental health.
Exactly. Good way to put it. Let's see, we pray for Roberto and Aaron.
Department of Health.
We pray for the Nantucket Cottage Hospital staff and volunteers, especially our dear parishioner Libby Tracy, who is a nurse practitioner there. And we pray
for my personal health guru.
We pray for the Fairwinds Counseling Center and staff.
Faith Frabel, do we pray for Dr. Frabel?
Dr. Faith Frabel, emergency room.
Lifesaver, we can testify right here.
Yeah.
On my right, your left.
We pray for Caitlin recovering from a bicycle accident. Aww.
Yes.
We pray for Lucy's family and Luke's family serving the medical community, and for first year nurse Sam in New York City. We pray for Jenny and Kirk. We give thanksgiving for Jenny and Kirk.
Yes, thank you.
We pray for all...
Reminding that, not to push, but that Jesus' first miracle, he made water into wine. I think it was Laurent Perrier champagne.
We pray for our homeless neighbors and
loved ones.
Exactly. All homeless and... Everyone we know that might be homeless, we pray especially for Emmanuel Shelter in Delaware, and we also pray for the Way Home Ministry, which is helping
ex-offenders yes. come out of prison to
find their
life.
Way once they're out of prison. So, a very important ministry.
Yeah. We have no prisons out here, all just temporary jails. We have our dear friend Sheriff Jim Perlman. Boy, if you had to be locked up, you'd want him as your sheriff. He's
yes.
the nicest man.
Yes,
it would be like a yoga experience. That's why Sherry teaches yoga. But it would be more mystical than abusive, that's for sure. Love our sheriff. He's one of the most popular people in Ireland. We don't have a mayor on it, but we have a sheriff that's elected.
Let's see, we pray for the med flight crews. I mean, every now and then I hear a helicopter flying over.
Yes,
over,
we pray when we do.
You know, and when I was in Mass General, I had a window view of the Charles River, and which is a very nice room. But anyway, I would, every now and then I'd hear a helicopter and see one go by. So... Let's pray for the med flight crews and the passengers they carry, and the Coast Guard crews, and for first responders. We pray for the Mission Committee of St. Paul's Church. We pray for children everywhere, and especially children at risk. We pray for all food providers, especially Julie and Matt, who work in... supermarkets and grocery stores, essential workers that they are. We pray for restaurant workers, Evan and Maria, chefs, Angela and Seth, Joe and Jordana, Todd and Susan, and all Nantucket chefs and restaurant workers. And also
especially Gabriel and for Mark Gottwald, across the street, our beloved parishioner.
And for Megan, a wonderful... employer of owner of restaurants.
She's a chef restaurant owner. And
an employer, yes, down in Rehoboth. We pray for our musical friends, Peggy and Sherman, and for our music director, Joe Hammer. We pray for Pastor Enoch Fuzz of Corinthian Church in Nashville.
Yes, Pastor Fuzz. We pray
for...
Fight on.
For Kathleen Waite's cousin and Peter's sister, Nancy. And we pray for Jenny's neighbor, Sally. And we pray for Noah McMillan. And for Paul for Mattiket.
Yes, and for Noah's doctors and caregivers, we could use some extra strength and wisdom in his treatment. So,
and we always let us remember to pray for justice and peace in our country and in our world.
Amen to that, Allie.
Sorry, it was a long one tonight, but...
Yes, my brother Johnny, on one of his feast days, actually he's probably named after John the Evangelist rather than John the Baptist, but John's an important name in my family, of course. John's named after my uncle who died in the war, shot down over Germany.
My mother said if I was born a boy, they were going to name me John.
John was going to be... No. You know, what movies are we serving? Get me a muffin, John. That was the butler's name or something. I'm going to say, isn't that for you, Allie?
That we got a chuckle out of.
It's like from the 50s.
He had to be there. Don't tell that story. He had to be there.
Well, I can start using that. I thought it was going to be your name wrong.
It was. My mother wanted to name me John if I was a boy.
Oh. That's precious. That's my confirmation name, Allie. We had to choose a confirmation name when I was confirmed. Mm-hmm. John was such an important name in my family. Okay, 134. What else, Allie? Our mission committee, today we give Thanksgiving for Mark and Edna from Nantucket Catering. Thanksgiving for the funding and collaboration, the wisdom from the Community Foundation for Nantucket and for their emergency relief fund. During this whole pandemic, they've been supporting chefs and restaurant people and, you know, hungry people, all kinds of workers keeping things going. And so anyways, community foundations throughout our country, but the Nantucket, I want to hold up for Thanksgiving. And so now our mission committee will be on, still again, many things in the happening, but we're going to be having some other things too coming forward. So keep us in your prayers for guidance, Allie.
Here,
and page 134. Okay, sure. You know this one. Mm-hmm. Let us pray together on the bottom of 134. Guide us waking, O Lord, and guard us sleeping,
that awake we may watch with Christ,
and asleep we may rest in peace. Lord, you now have set your servant free to go in peace as you have promised. For these eyes of mine have seen the Savior, whom you prepared for all the world to see. A light to enlighten the nations, and the glory of your people Israel. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Guide us waking, O Lord, and guard us sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep we may rest in peace. Let us bless the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Thanks be to God, Allie.
Thanks be to God.
Yeah, sorry, I closed the book
thanks
too quickly.
Thanks be to God, amen.
Thanks be to God, amen. Hallelujah. Just one, though.
It all works.
Okay, Diana, you're in our prayers. You're in Mozart, and I know our poor Esme is struggling, but again, we savor every minute we have with our precious critters. Those have been some of my saddest...
Oh, but I've dreams again. It's not like that. But
no, I know. But yeah, I have dreams of.
We're just sad that she had to spend the night. We don't like that, you know.
Yeah.
So, and she's a little.
She'll bounce back.
Bed is empty.
I know. So let me put the machine on. Put the machine on. Yes. So I have the scallop show here in the window for baptism on it. Didn't use any of my props.
All right. So tonight I went looking on. Max said, find a song about the River Jordan. So, I found this. It's Rance Allen. I don't know who that is, but it's a gospel rendition. I stood on the banks of the Jordan. Okay, here we go.
What year? get those Hammond organs, Allie. I'm going to get one of these to Joe Hammer.
That's perfect.
Right?
Joe Hammer. Call Joe Hammond. Hammond.
That's an old joke, too, from yesterday, Allie. Lead it when you come, Joseph. You're going to bring up to the attic.
That's right. When you come, Joseph, you're going to be up here with us. Anyone that comes and visits.
It's hard to see in the phone. Can't. Sorry. Yeah. Rance Allen. R-I-N-C-E. It's bigger than me, Allie. It's bigger than me. Now you know my secret. Oh, you get the hairspray? Unless I go to the barber soon, I need one for my eyebrows. Well, look at. My dad's eyebrows now. Rocking chair for church, I'm telling you. Cracker Barrel, those Cracker Barrel rocket chairs. River Jordan. Not the Thames. Not the Nile. Tomorrow. Oh, Bible study tomorrow if you get time, 11:30, 12:30, take the course, Bible study. Let me know if you want to zoom in or call in. All right. Love you. The Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace. Sweet dreams, Joseph, too. Sweet dreams. Thanks for staying late.